Hi guys, if you are looking at the empty screen of your Qt simulator and instead you should be looking at the hello world message, you are at the right place. If you see message module com.nokia.symbian is not installed, import com.nokia.symbian 1.1, then you are in luck. If you only wanted to run simple Hello World app using Qt Quick Components for Symbian, then this video is for you. I'm using Qt SDK 1.1.4 and it's based on the Qt 4.7.4. When I try to enter design editor of any of the QML pages, I get message QML model not found. So if you have a problem like this and you want to know how to solve it, or if you don't have a problem like this and you want to know how to reproduce it, continue watching this video. First, let's see how to reproduce this problem. I will first close this project. And I will create a new project. File, new file project. I will choose Qt Quick project, Qt Quick application, choose. I have specified a working folder, Qt Work Learning, located on the C drive. And I will call this test components app. Hit next. Qt Quick application type should be Qt Quick components for Symbian. Next. Target should be Symbian device and Qt simulator. Next. Target UID can stay. Enable network access, next, and we're not going to add any version control or anything else, so just click finish. So basically this is a template that's generated completely automatically, and I haven't changed anything from it. So it has the main CPP. It has the main QML and main page. When I hit build and run at the same time, as you will see, we will get the error module com.nokia.symbian is not installed. And now, as you can see, there is no hello world message in the simulator, and we got the message. So the question is how to fix this. Easy. Go to help, start updater. This will run a little program called maintain Qt SDK. You can even run this program through start all programs, Qt SDK, and maintain Qt SDK. As you can see, it has launched and it's looking for the update components on the internet. Now it won't find any because this version of the Qt is up to date, but it will show us that there are some packages left uninstalled. So we should choose Package Manager. Hit next. Okay, so you should definitely make this bigger so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so go under APIs, Qt Quick Components for Symbian, Qt Quick Components for Symbian Simulator, it's this one, and as you can see, Qt Quick Components for Symbian MinGW is not checked. You should check it. Hit next. This component contains MinGW simulator version of Qt Quick Components for Symbian. So we are definitely using this version of simulator, and we should click next, update. It's downloading, and afterwards you should restart the Qt SDK and it should work. Hit next, hit restart, and just close maintain Qt SDK. Yes. Now if we hit build and run again, we will see that the application is starting, the simulator is working correctly. It has created a new tab and it says hello world, and we have a back button that will close our app when we hit it. Okay, and at the same time, if we go to the designer, wait for it to load. By the way, my laptop is very, very old, and usually Qt is much faster than this. Okay, so I have to restart the Qt creator and it will work afterwards. Try it out yourself. Okay, so that's basically that. This is my first tutorial ever. So if you like it, just hit like, subscribe. It will give me some kind of feedback from you, and hopefully I will create some more tutorials for Qt and Qt Quick for Symbian mobile phones. Thanks, bye.